you know, when my great-grandfather came from Russia, you know what he said? He had it very right, and he had the Bible as his guide. He said, the rights of the land are ours because this is our land. This is why I came back, because this is our ancestral homeland.
The Jewish ancestral homeland is the whole of British Mandate Palestine, the ancestral homeland of the Jews. When we look at the map of this ancient territory, we see the kingdom of Edom, the kingdom of Moab, and the kingdom of Judah, which is only a very small bit, and that is the homeland of the Judeans, Judah, because the kingdom of Israel to the north was not a Jewish kingdom. I repeat, it was not a Jewish kingdom. The kingdom of Israel was a Samaritan kingdom. Yes, Samaritan. That's where the Samaritans came from. The word Samaritan comes from the word Samarim, and it means guardians, keepers. Guardians and keepers of the law, which is the Torah. The Samarim themselves, the Samaritans themselves, call themselves Bene Yisrael, or the children of Israel. They are the descendants of the ancient kingdom of Israel, also known as Samaria, and they view their religion as the same as that of the ancient Israelites, because the Samaritans still live today. Not many, just a few. In fact, during the Roman era, just about the time of the Third Samaritan Revolt in the 6th century AD, against the Roman occupation, the Samaritans numbered about 1 million people, which means that they were actually the majority in Roman-occupied Palestine at that time. In fact, as Sean Ireton of the University of Kent published in 2003, a great many of present-day Palestinians are, in fact, descendants of the Samaritans, who converted through the centuries to either Christianity or Islam. The Samaritans believe that they have the true, unadulterated Israelite religion and reject the teachings and scriptures of the Jews. And until the 17th century AD, they possessed a high priesthood descending directly from Aaron through Eleazar and Phinehas. They claim to have continuously occupied their ancient territory, and according to the Samaritan Chronicle 2, Sefer HaYamim, after the death of Joshua, Eli, the priest, left the tabernacle which Moses erected in the desert and established on Mount Gerizim. Eli was the son of Jephne, and he decided to usurp the high priesthood from the descendants of Phinehas. And after Eli failed to take over the priesthood, he and a group of his followers went to Shiloh, and there he built a temple for himself. Eventually, this led to division between the kingdom of Israel and the kingdom of Judah, the Samaritan kingdom of Israel and a Judean kingdom of Judah. The Judean Jews claim that for a short period, the kingdom of Israel and the kingdom of Judea were united under the rule of David and Solomon. However, archaeology is unequivocal. There was never the wealth, population, political cohesion or literacy in the tiny settlement around the village of Jerusalem to have ever dominated its more developed northern neighbor, Samaritan Israel. The so-called united monarchy is found only in the Bible. The empire has no monuments, no inscriptions, and no artifacts. Neither David nor Solomon is as much as mentioned in the huge corpus of state records of either Egypt or Assyria. The north was larger, richer, and more developed. All the crown structures, which were previously attributed by Zionist archaeologists to King Solomon, have turned out to be, in fact, projects of the Samaritan Kingdom of Israel. The conclusion accepted by a majority of the new archaeologists and Bible scholars was that there never was a great united monarchy. in reality there were distinctive kingdoms, one in Samaria, Israel, Samaritan, and one in Judah from the 9th century onwards. Now it is a fact that the oldest found synagogue in the world is indeed a Samaritan synagogue. And Israel is already mentioned in the Merneh Ptah Stela from Egypt in the 13th century BC, whilst the Kingdom of Judah consolidated only in the late 8th century BC. And in fact, in the 9th century BC, there were only about 20 small villages in what was to become the Kingdom of Judah. And Jerusalem was really just a small village. So archaeologically, the Kingdom of Israel is definitely older than the Kingdom of Judah. But is it also older religiously? And indeed, the Samaritan Torah is written in ancient Hebrew, whilst the Masoretic Torah, which is used by the modern Jewry worldwide, is written in a square script Hebrew alphabet, which is actually a stylized version of the Aramaic alphabet adopted from the Persian Empire. The oldest Masoretic Torah that is found dates back to the 9th century AD, so well into the Muslim rule over Palestine. The Samaritan Torah, on the other hand, is more closely related to the oldest Torah that we know of, which is the Septuagint, the Greek Torah from Alexandria, dating to the 2nd century before Christ. Eusebius of Caesarea wrote that the Greek translation differs from the Hebrew one, though not so much from the Samaritan. Jean Morin argued that the Samaritan Pentateuch's correspondences with the Latin Vulgate and the Greek Septuagint indicated that it represents a more authentic Hebrew text than the Masoretic text. In 1915, Paul Kahle concluded that the Samaritan Pentateuch preserves many genuine old readings and an ancient form of the Pentateuch. Frank Moorcross states that the Samaritan and the Septuagint share a nearer common ancestor than either does with the Masoretic text. Now we come to point 4. In accordance with the Torah, where clearly the priesthood and the prophethood is passed on through the male line, Israeli Samaritism can only be inherited through the father. And since the Torah clearly states that God made a covenant with the children of Abraham, you cannot become a Samaritan unless you are born as one. Contrary to that, in Judaism, people that are not the descendants of Abraham can convert to Judaism, or people inherited through the female line. And this rule in Judaism is not based on the Torah. It actually comes from the Mishnah, Kiddushin 3.12. And it was written by Rabbi Judah Hanasi in 220 AD, 220 current time, during the Roman era. The Samaritan claim that they are the descendants of the original Israelites, going back all the way to the tribes of Jacob, is confirmed by genetic research that was done in 2004. An article was published by Shen, and it indicated that most of the Samaritans can be traced back to the paternally inherited Israelite high priesthood, Kohanim, whilst the majority of present-day Jews can genetically not, I repeat, cannot genetically be traced back to the paternally inherited Israelite priesthood. Now, looking at the might and size of the Samaritan Kingdom of Israel as compared to the small Kingdom of Judah, then how is it possible that modern-day Jews who believe that they are descendants of the people of Judah claim the whole of Palestine as their ancestral homeland? The archaeological and historical evidence shows that there never was a united kingdom So that cannot be the reason. Their claim on the land seems to go back to the Roman province of Palestine. But where did that Roman province of Palestine come from?
Now what happened was that in the first century before Christ, to the south of Judah, in the kingdom of Edom, there was a guy called Herod, and he was an Edomite. And today the scholars think that the Edomites were a Bedou people. They were definitely not Judeans. And this Edomite called Herod went to Rome.
And he said to Rome, if you help me to conquer the throne of Judah, I will be a loyal subject for your interests in this area.
Knowing very well that Rome needed the wealth of Egypt, and therefore Rome needed some vassal states in the Near East to protect Rome's lifelines to Egypt.
And so they decided to help Herod with some Roman legions to become the king of Judah. And that's how Herod the Great became a Roman client king, and Judah thus became a strongly dependent ally of Rome. And after the demise of Herod's dynasty, early first century after Christ, the Romans took direct control of its investment, and thus they made Judah into the Roman province of Judaea.
And it was the Romans who combined the former kingdoms of Edom and Judea with Israel, also known as Samaria, into this new province, which soon would be renamed as the Roman province of Palestine. And the capital of this new Roman province was not Jerusalem, no, it was Caesarea in the Samaritan heartland, Israel. How awkward it is that a worldwide Jewry claimed the whole of Palestine and that everybody else has to move out, based on the fact that once the little kingdom of Judah was a small part of the Roman province of Palestine. Stranger still is that they hijacked the name of the Samaritan Kingdom of Israel, whilst the still surviving Samaritans today are not even considered Jews by the Zionist state of so-called Israel. Truth is stranger than fiction. You couldn't make it up, even if you tried.